Hey everyone, Ethan Ainsworth here. I wanted to do another gaming video, so we're going to do top 5 NES classics or essentials for under $10. Now, this is not necessarily in a specific order, but I did arrange them sort of in order of what my favorite games are. I tried to get a game from every genre here. So there's action, action adventure platformer, there's RPG, there's puzzle, there's sports. You got the whole shebang here, and they're all under $10. So the first one on the list here is Tetris. Tetris is a fantastic game. Tetris is a great puzzle game. It can be either slow paced or high speed depending on what you want. It's a terrific multiplayer game. You'll notice that a couple of times here is the multiplayer aspect. So you can bring over a friend and you can play this on your Nintendo or on your simulation or whatever you want to call it. But yeah, Tetris is a game that no NES collection would really truly be complete without, in my opinion. Next, we have Double Dragon. Now, this is an all-time classic beat-em-up. I think we all know Double Dragon. Anybody who's familiar with NES is familiar with Double Dragon. This is a great game. It gets a little monotonous, gets a little tired after a while, but if you've got a friend over and you're sitting on the couch together, you can't go wrong with Double Dragon. Fantastic classic game. Next, we have Blades of Steel. Now, this is appealing to the sports genre, the sports fan. However, I'm not a sports fan at all. In fact, I really don't like sports games. I love Blades of Steel. Blades of Steel is one of those sports games that you don't have to be a sports fan to enjoy. It's like NBA Jam. This is a more arcade style game. I was playing this with my little brother yesterday, and it's fantastic. I mean, like, you can't go wrong with this. The controls are intuitive. They're fun. There's combat in the game, believe it or not. It's terrific. I really do recommend this game as a non-sports fan or as a sports fan. Number 4, we've got Rygar. This is the RPG of the list. This is really fun. This is like Castlevania, Simon's Quest, if it wasn't cryptic. basically, it's sort of like a mix between Castlevania and Zelda, if you ask me. It's a 2D platformer, but you have to explore the world. You have to learn mythology and find clues and weapons and items and stuff. And ultimately save the day, and it's a great game. The owner of the game store here, Doug, recommended this to me several years ago, so I picked it up. This is fantastic, and I you can't go wrong with Rygar. Rygar is an all-time favorite of mine in terms of NES RPGs. Last but not least, my favorite game. In this list, in one of my favorite games on the NES, it's hard as hell, it's balls to the wall action. I've beaten it once, I'll never beat it again, probably. This is Batman on the NES. This game is fantastic, and I can't believe this is still less than $10. If you don't have this game in your NES collection, you're doing it wrong. This game is based off the 1989 Michael Keaton classic, Tim Burton classic, Batman. And it's fantastic. It has really, really, really awesome cutscenes. The enemies are fun. It's hard as hell, but it's fair. And that's what I love. Games that are hard but fair. You know, you don't want to play a game that's hard just because it's crap. You want to play a game that's hard because it's well designed. And this is that. This is great for any Batman fan. This is like a more fair version of Ninja Gaiden. It's a better programmed version of Ninja Gaiden, if you ask me. And you can't go wrong. I love this game. It's absolutely fantastic. And you'll tear your hair out trying to fight the Joker. But nonetheless, I want to thank you for watching. This has been a lot of fun to put together. You know, it was surprisingly fast to put all these games together. It seemed like it was really intuitive. All these games are terrific, and I would recommend any one of them to anybody. But those are my top 5 essential NES games for under $10. So thank you for watching. And I appreciate it. Like, subscribe, give me a comment because I need friends. And I'll talk to you guys later.